Happy Thursday. Workout 17.2 of the CrossFit Games Open was released tonight. It is a 12-minute AMRAP of dumbbell walking lunges, toes to bar or muscle ups, and then dumbbell cleans to the shoulders. In my opinion, for those dumbbell walking lunges, the name of the game there is going to be steady pace and consistency. For folks who start sprinting through those, heart rate's going to get through the roof and a couple of things might happen. Back knee might not touch the ground, the hips might not extend all the way up in between, and when that heart rate spikes, it's going to be awfully hard to bring it back down during the other movements in the workout. So find a pace and just keep yourself moving. What I'd suggest, 25 unbroken feet every time. Take a rest if you need to, 25 unbroken feet back. Don't stop in the middle if you don't have to. Then, with those toes to bar, we did a workout last year that had toes to bar that had a lot of athletes at a very high level going down to singles or doubles. So just because athletes have the ability to do 16 toes to bar in a row when they're fresh, gonna be a grip burner on this one. I would suggest not doing large sets, sets of four, although it may sound ridiculous to some people now. By the time you get back to the third or the fourth round of the workout, if that happens, I think that's gonna be a smart bet to start small and maintain versus burning out and then starting to miss singles as we get tired. For the bar muscle ups, same concept there, only people typically tend to know how many bar muscle ups they can link in a row. If you end up getting burned out really early on, it's gonna be a lot of time sitting up there just staring at the bar, knowing you're not gonna be able to get it until you rest a lot longer. So small, manageable sets out of the gate, hop down, shake it out, even if it's singles, then go back up. To keep yourself moving as an athlete is gonna be the way to go on this one instead of burning out on any one of these movements and being crushed by the end. For the power cleans, just like the dumbbell snatches I talked about last week, it's gonna be possible to look very ugly and muscle one's way through that. Try not to. Save your back, be smart, realize this is exercise racing. I don't wanna see anybody get hurt. However, if you do it right, there can be a nice smooth rhythm to these, just like there were last week for the dumbbell snatches. For the scaled versions, a little bit of a better workout. Hanging knee raises and chin over the bar pull-ups. On the pull-ups, there you can go a little bit if you want. Larger sets will be much more common there. For the knee raises, when we coach here at least, we'll typically say get those knees up as high to the chest as you can, really curl up into a ball. This is competition mode now. The range of motion requirement is knees above the waist. Just get them up as high as you need to, go right back down and keep cycling through. Be smart, move fast, also keep that heart rate under control there. Grip, name of the game on this one. Heart rate, keep it down and under control. Now let's go and talk about some range of motion stuff. So based on the live feed, it looked like you're allowed to hold the dumbbells vertically on your shoulders. If that's allowed, I'd probably suggest trying to do that from here. Safely get the dumbbells up. If you can get in a position where the dumbbells are comfortable and you can have less of a grip on them, it's going to be a lot easier to walk and keep yourself moving. If that's going to be a mess and you're going to be wobbling and fumbling with them, practice just that standard front rack. From here, maybe you'll alternate, but make sure don't miss any reps. We expect to be tired holding these weights. They're not super light, but if you're trying to be clever and hold them up here, and you just can't stabilize, it's gonna add a lot more time and a lot more stress to your reps. The Open's always a fun time to see people get their very first bar muscle up, but gotta make sure that you remember, only the hands can help for the rep to count. So for all the folks who get their first one by leaning over, landing on their forearm and pressing up, that's not gonna count this year. Let's be smart. With a lot of folks, grip starts to go fast with one really large set of unbroken bar muscle ups. Doesn't make sense to do that if you're planning on getting back to them. 16 reps per round is a ton. If that means quick singles, do that. Hop up, lock it out, shake it down, boom, and continue. From here, hop it up. Resting here is allowed. This is what you need to do to regrip a little bit. Regroup, not a problem. Come back down and resume, but this is gonna be fatiguing and you're holding dumbbells at your shoulders half the other time of the workout. So, hopping down, giving yourself 3 to 5 breaths, and continuing might be a much better option. No need to sit in a position where you're under tension or having to support yourself if that's not gonna help you in the long run. Pace those out, quick singles might be the way to go for a lot of people. For the dumbbell cleans, only one head of the dumbbell has to touch the ground. That's awesome news for most of us. What I would suggest, get that palm of your hand here on the ridge as close to the top of the head of the dumbbell as possible, so that when you're in that top locked out position, you can go right back down and get that firm, stable grip on that dumbbell. With both hands at the same time, it's gonna be a little different. What I want you to think about doing, staying under control. While muscle cleans are an option, if you get tired, those can get pretty ugly. A little power clean is totally fine. From here, extend the hips quick. Boom, that'll save a lot of energy. However, if you've got 50-pound dumbbells smashing on your shoulders every single rep, it's gonna get old pretty fast. Gotta be smart. Please be careful. Don't hurt yourself because you're trying to get the dumbbells up there quickly. Find that steady rhythm. Just like last week, however, a lot of possibility and potential to bend down and muscle those weights up. Try your best to keep that integrity. Keep your chest high, back as flat as possible, and do your reps that way. Even though you can muscle and round your back, that's gonna add up and people might get hurt. If you've got the momentum to do an almost kettlebell swing-like rep, that's fine, but keep it tight. So, from the ground, momentum is fine. Just don't do it at the expense of rounding your back. Be safe, please. Eight's a lot. You don't have to do those unbroken throughout the entire workout.